best of the best two. We start now with the WKN European title eliminator in A-class Thai kickboxing. Paul Wheeler against Wayne McCoy. It's sure to be an excellent fight.
Paul Wheeler looks fired.
Paul Wheeler looks fired. In the right corner. Wayne McCoy in the blue.
Here we go. Paul's doing exactly what expected. Straight in. He's going to pressurise from the beginning. This is where Wayne's doing. This is his best part, the knees. He's doing exactly as I would do. Tie up the hands, bring the knees in.
He needs to tie those hands up because Paul's got very good boxing training.
Exceptional boxing. It's his training. Will Kelly's a very good boxing training as well. It's exactly as expected. Fire from the beginning. He's going to have to watch the knees, Paul Wheeler. They break ribs very easily. Wayne McCoy is a knee expert. It comes as no surprise what's happening now. Knee versus punch up. As long as Wayne keeps tight in the middle, I see no problems for him. But as soon as he lets go, he's going to be in trouble.
What are the main targets that Wayne will be looking for when he brings those knees out?
Look for the ribs. The ribs and solar plexus. And he is an expert at doing that. Every fight I've seen him in, he is the knee technician. In my view, he'll do great in Thailand, Holland and France because of his Thai boxing ability. He's got to watch those hands. This guy can punch. For 5 rounds, I think he could do 10 if it was that far. That's where you've got to watch it. He's tagging him with a hand.
An explosive start though, from both men.
It is.
They're not showing each other any respect that he's going for it.
I also feel that Wheeler's fitness level to me has always been so high. He's able to fight this press the whole way through. I haven't seen Wayne in such pressurised fights like this, so remains to be seen whether he can do the 4-5-2s.
Now with Thai boxing, as we said earlier, the referee will quite happy to let them catch as long as they're working, won't he?
That's right. As long as they continue to work, as long as the knees are thrown, he will allow it to continue. As soon as they start dragging close together and get into a position where there's no knees exchange, he will split them.
Paul Wheeler's ribcage already looking very red.
Very, very red. Paul's got to do something about this. He's got to get out of that clinch. Wayne is far too good at that. Oh! As I said, he has to time up tight.
Right at the end of the round there as well, Alan. It'll give Wayne time to recover.
I think so. It's definitely shivers not. A superb punch. As I said, Paul Wheeler, he's got up against people with knees before and he's used to bringing them over the top. I suggest now that either Wayne tightens up his clinch work.
Let's look at this again, Alan. And as you said, Wayne's doing all the clinch work. Then this right.
Awesome knees as well. And then he lets it down and here it comes. Here we go. Bam.
Very short right and very, very little pullback, was there?
I would, if I was Wayne now, after seeing that, I would go at the distance. I'd keep away from Wheeler, firing the 1-2s, using the left jab. He's got the height, he's got longer arms, better reach. He's gonna...
So here we go, we're getting ready for the second round. Alan, if you caught that, would that knock down? How did you see that first round?
That's a 10-8 round to Paul Wheeler, in my opinion. Back again. Excellent counter kick. They seem to really, it's been non-stop action the whole way. Wayne's got to be careful, that guy's really sticking out. He's throwing some lethal kicks in now. With Paul Wheeler's ribcage is really looking very ridden and bruised.
How long in this sort of fight, knowing this one's 5 rounds, will Paul be able to take that punishment to the ribcage before it really starts?
Paul is so strong, I wouldn't put it on him to take that for 5 rounds. I'm saying that if a rib cracks, the fight's going to be over. I'm really surprised that Wayne doesn't use more of his hands. He's got a beautiful right hand.
But he's took another heavy right there in that corner.
He's not used to taking this kind of pressure. I don't think this is going to last. I can't see it lasting at this pace.
Well, it is lasting. That's a superb fight, Alan.
Even Paul Willis throwing the knees in himself. It's not something we've seen too often. He's got to keep his guard up, though. He can't be complacent with Wayne McCoy. One thing these two guys will be sore tomorrow. There's a lot of kicks to do here. It's the most exciting part I've seen tonight.
I'd just like to ask you, Alan, is this the fight you were hoping for?
It certainly is. This is exactly what I expected. Neo versus Puncher. Clinch vs. Puncher. Wayne must keep his guard high in that pitch. Paul's an expert for him over the top. He's done exactly that in the first round.
So at the moment, Wayne McCoy under pressure.
Now he's being clever moving away. He's got a knee and move, knee and move. Don't stand the trade. Paul Wheeler is far too strong for that. Oh, almost a knee to the head there. It's not allowed under these rules. Elbows and knees that are not permitted. Only in A-class fights. Usually for European and world title fights.
Again, we're going to go with a short right and a strong left.
This is what he's good at. This is his kind of fight. Getting in there, trading up. McCoy seems to be lining up some ideas there.
Excellent second round there, 2 of 5, two explosive rounds. Alan, how are you scoring this so far?
I've got Paul Wheeler ahead of 10-8 in the first round. I would say 10-9 on it because he's landing the more damaging accurate shots. Where McCoy was more surviving.
Let's look at some of this action in that corner. Talk us through this, Alan.
Yeah. You can see Ryan's landing heavy shots, but Paul Wheeler's is so strong and so tough, he can't really take punishment.
He's coming back with his punches well. He's working the ribs as well. He does seem a natural boxer, Wheeler.
He is. The only way he's going to get stopped or beaten is to fight someone with boxing ability.
If you're in Wayne's corner now, what would you say to this?
You can move, knee and move. He's staying after the knees, and ought to be moving away. That's exactly, he's moving into Wheeler's territory.
Now we're in Paul Wheeler's corner on the monitor at the moment. Do you think they're happy with what they see?
I would say so. As I know Will Kelly very well, he doesn't look like he's panicking in any way. He seems confident of his ball winning. I think he's expecting a knockout here.
18 years of age though, Wayne McCoy, so strong.
Phenomenal. An athlete. He's in absolutely superb condition as well, as you can see. But I've never really seen him on a really big pressure for 5 rounds. He's going to start really quick. Oh, brilliant shot. Superb.
That right combination there.
Wheeler's eye appears to be coming up as well.
It is. He's marked under the eye. Alan is beginning to swell, but I think McCoy shocked him with his out punch combination.
He's come back again. Another really great kick. And Wheeler's is so incredibly tough. He's taking kicks and punches with seemingly no effect.
His short rights and short lefts from him.
It's just a war. A total war. Appears to be Wayne McCoy's complaining of a low blow. I didn't see it myself, but you can't always see everything that goes on there. This is so explosive.
It is, this is non-stop here. Wheeler's seeing the problem from the boy. It seems to be that Wheeler's prepared to walk through his work to land his own shots. And he brings those hooks in and those uppercuts in very short. You don't see them coming. There's no looping in this fight.
None whatsoever. It's 100%. It's exactly as I anticipated. A total war. With Paul Wheeler being ahead, but you never know. As I said, McCoy can't pull these hooks out of the tree. Yeah, this is more like what he should be doing, sticking and moving. Don't keep standing there. That's dangerous. This is exactly what you do not need. And the bell's gone.
The noise here is so intense that we can't hear the bell. The referee is asking, can they ring it louder? But they can't hear it. But that sums up the fight, really. The guy's not even stopping at the end of the round.
I don't think I've had a second to blink here. It's just been total, all the way, toe-to-toe. An amazing fight. This is what the audience want to see.
Look at this here, Alan. Bringing the knees, as you said again. This has been the pattern throughout the whole fight, hasn't it? This shocks Paul Wheeler, the fact that...
Very much so, but still walking straight through. Incredible. You really have to be, you've got to be really on your game to beat this guy. What he needs to do is sustain that punch, you know what? Maybe a 1, 2, 3, 4, and then the kick.
Yeah, he took a heavy kick to the head.
Big heavy kick. Although that kick did appear slightly pulled. What he's got to do is try and sustain his punch attacks on the corner. He killed him there, he just followed up afterwards.
So would we both agree that Paul Wheeler's beginning to just slightly pull away now?
Yeah. Saying that, Wheeler's very good in the final round. I've never seen him falter, ever once. As you can see, he even comes up strong in. Again, he's caught him. But he's got to follow up, he's allowed him to recover. If he keeps him at bay with that cheek, that front kick called the cheek on top.
There's a cut, that last kick cut Wheeler's eye, he's cut above the left eye.
Cut, he's flowing freely. There's no pity, too big a cut, as early days will tell you.
It's long though, Alan.
McCoy's doing what he should do now. You see, he's hitting and moving, as I said in the earlier rounds. Hit, move.
He's looking at encouragement, Alan. He's seen the blood. It's a long cut. I don't know how deep it is, but it's definitely from a kick.
Wheeler's in trouble now. Wheeler was in trouble there.
He's bleeding freely from that cut. That's definitely going real hard, Alan.
Real hard. He seems to have stepped off the gas with the punches as well. Whether his eyesight from the eyes going down, I don't
think
know.
That took Wheeler by surprise.
I think so.
Now, as we thought, it's going to be looked at here. It is long.
Oh, it is a big cut. I can see it. It's across really the opened up now.
It's across the length of the eye. It was by a legitimate kick. The doctor's not very happy with
it. Feeling the stops is it will go to McCoy because it was done by a legitimate move. I would think they're in a fourth round. They may let it continue. Yes, they are. But now, Wheeler's got to end this. That cut's got this too bad to continue. If McCoy stays at bay, he's going to have this.
You don't think they'll allow Wheeler out for the fifth round?
They may not. The cut's very bad. They said he's got a big fight coming up in 5 weeks.
McCoy's found a new lease of life, though, Alan, hasn't he?
He has. He's got to move, though. He mustn't stay in that corner.
But again, that right found the mark on that cut.
He's slipped on the ropes there. He needs to get out of that court.
He's looking again, though, Alan. That's twice he's landed on the open wound. He's looking for that right hand to open that wound up.
He knows he's there. He's able to do it before. But he mustn't be complacent. He must get away from Wheeler. Fight away from him.
Oh, the big right hand on the cut.
Wheeler's coming back is phenomenal.
Alan, this fight really has exceeded expectations here.
The bell's gone again. Again, they can hear the bell. They continue.
The fourth, though, Alan, but they must be worrying Paul Wheeler's corner now. That's
my last. My prediction is for this next round, Wheeler will come out very, very, very strong. I give that. The last round was definitely McCoy's, possibly the round before, so that brings them even. Depending whether they're given an award of 10-8 for that first round. If they're awarded 10-8, then Wheeler's 1 point ahead. They're 10-8, 10-9. I'll give McCoy round 3 and 4. So he's got to win this last round or put Wheeler down. If Wheeler wins this last round, it's too close. Even with the cut doesn't count for.
It's a very bad though. You can see the working there, though. It's along the end. Oh, very good. The eye there, though. At least half the eyebrow. Let's have a look, see if this is where it's done, Alan. Got him in the corner where he's been for most of the fight, to be honest. They've fought in these corners. McCoy bantering well here. Just now the cuts, the damage already done here. But McCoy, as you said, sticking and moving now very well, isn't he?
He is. He's gone out. If he moves away and keeps this to win this round, my feeling is he's won the fight.
So fifth
he's still very close,
round.
Though. Very close. Wheeler's going to have to stop him because of that cut. It's all hinging on this round.
Everything to fight for here.
He's taking a heavy duty punishment. He's going to feel this tomorrow, I can tell you. He's getting that cut hit again. He's got to get in close and shut that down. Always caught McCoy again. McCoy appears to have an amazing distance. Oh, keep the distance now. He's hit that cut again with a high kick. Oh! Awesome high kick from McCoy. Kind of balance there. Appears to have no effect on Wheeler. Walks right through the action. And now Wheeler's back on the gas again.
McCoy looks tired now though, Alan.
Wheeler's winning this round again. If he wins this round, my feeling is he's won the fight. McCoy must keep him at bay.
Oh, he's hurt and the kick now. He's not quite there. McCoy
is finishing it. He's going in for the kill. This is incredible fight. Durability of these two fighters, the Seneca, I have not seen for a very long time.
McCoy's down.
A real shame, it's an amazing fight.
There's the final bell. Well, Alan, what an incredible fight.
Phenomenal.
Possibly the fight of the night here tonight. Two durable men.
I don't think you can contest that. We've still got one bout left, but an amazing fight.
Here we go then, Alan. We've got the decision, Paul Shard, to announce it. We think we know it's Wheeler. We'll be very surprised when we if it's not.
After the full 5 2-minute rounds, the judges have awarded 133.5 points to Wayne McCoy and 150 points to Paul Wheeler.
Big score there, big score.